Say cheese. Say cheese.
Cheese.
Good job. Granny, say cheese.
Cheese.
I wanted to show y'all, this is the Rose of Sharon that we planted last year. And it is blooming, and that's, I think, the second or third bloom. And if you see, there are buds all over the plant. So what I did to make it bush out more, and I'm really pleased so far with the growth this year, is I've taken the central plant that came up, because, you know, usually it sends up a main plant and then it has maybe some others. I pinched off the top of that like this. And it kind of is like, oh, I don't want to do that. But if your goal is to make it bush instead of come up like a tree, you want to pinch off that top part, because what it does is it removes the totipotent cells so that the plant no longer can continue growing from that stem. And this plant goes, oh no, what do I do to continue growing? And it will start sending off side shoots, and it creates that more bushy effect. And most plants, I'm not going to say all, but most plants are that way. And then these right here, that one and this one, are cuttings that I took this year from Grandma's plant and potted up. The reason I went ahead and did it right away is because last year I took the purple cuttings and pink cuttings and put them in this pot and another, but then we got too much water and they died out. Oh, and look, the pineapple sage is doing wonderfully, and this is the one from last year. It overwintered and came back good and strong. And then we have some four clocks and mint and maybe a little lemon balm. But what I wanted to show you real quick, sorry, forget the messy kitchen, is that I did the same method. We have a video. Check out that video. I rooted in water and then I potted up because I don't want to lose these. Y'all have a blessed day, and we'll talk to you more next time here at Kooker Gahoof.